It's the end of day two at the United Nations climate talks here in Durban, South Africa. I'm going to try and give you a quick wrap-up of some of the main outcomes from today, but I want to start 7,000 miles away in Brazil first, because there's some important developments there. There's a vote taking place to change the country's forest code, and campaigners are very worried that this could result in forest loss of something like a combination of Germany, Austria and Italy combined. Clearly a huge issue, and we're going to make sure we keep on top of that story over the coming days. Bringing it back down to the talks though, we said yesterday that there'd been a lot of aggression towards Canada from campaigners. They've come out and they've said that they're thinking about withdrawing from the Kyoto Protocol. It's not been confirmed by the government yet, but it's numerous sources in Canadian papers and Canadian TV. The Environment Minister's come out and said he's refusing to either confirm or deny it. The response of the NGOs and civil society campaigners here in Durban yesterday was one of alarm, really. But it seems overnight they've calmed down a little, and rather than aggressively attacking Canada, they've been coming out and saying Canada's quickly becoming a bad joke at these negotiations. They're negotiating in bad faith, and really they need to get out of the way. The US has come in for some criticism today because of comments from their lead negotiator, Jonathan Pershing, which have been described as outrageous by some campaigners. He said that there was an infinite number of pathways to stay below 2 degrees Celsius, so that means to keep global warming at somewhat safe levels. Campaigners have been quick to point out that if there really is an infinite number of pathways to stay safe, it's surprising that the US is managing to avoid every single one of them. Regarding one of the biggest issues here, which is the future of the Kyoto Protocol, that's probably going to become clearer next week when ministers arrive. So again, it's something we'll carry on following, and we'll be talking to policy experts over the coming days, and we'll make sure you're in the loop on that story. And finally, regarding the future of these talks, a decision was made today that next year's conference of parties, next year's year in climate talks, will take place in Qatar, in Doha. Qatar actually has the third largest emissions per capita on the planet, and as you can imagine, it's a decision that hasn't been met with great enthusiasm from campaigners here. So there's just a quick wrap-up from today. We'll be starting our live show tomorrow at 3 o'clock local time, so do tune in. Thank you.